Hi, I'm Andy Boeber, Senior Director of Applied AI and Intelligent Automation at Pega. I'm here with Ivar Siccama, our Senior Product Manager for Machine Learning and AI. Ivar has years and years of experience in decisioning in AI, and I'm thrilled we can both share with you what's new in Process AI in our Infinity 23 release. Thanks for joining us today, Ivar.
Thanks, Andy. Yes, it's great to be here to show all these new enhancements we have in Process AI in the upcoming Infinity 23 release.
Absolutely. And Ivar, you know, we both just got back from Pega World. Our customers and everybody here at Pega are really, really pumped up about Infinity 23. We don't have time to cover everything in detail today, but we'll hit on a few key themes for Process AI. First, we've made it extremely easy, not that it wasn't already easy, to integrate AI directly into your business processes. There's a lot you can do directly in App Studio, as you'll see in a moment. Secondly, we've expanded some of our specific out-of-the-box AI capabilities with new features like Predict Any Field. And lastly, we've continued to invest heavily in the underlying decisioning and AI infrastructure, as well as our supporting materials to make it easy for you to try Process AI and put it into production. But before we jump straight into our new features, it's worth spending a minute to articulate the breadth of AI that Pega provides and how Process AI and all of our exciting new generative AI capabilities complement each other. We look at Process AI as the left brain, focused on sensing the environment and then applying real-time, low-latency decisioning and analytics that improves overall business effectiveness and efficiency. For example, understanding if a given case is going to meet its SLA or not lets organizations improve routing and work sequencing. Generative AI, on the other hand, is more the right brain, more the creative side. Low coders can use generative AI and Pega now to help build new apps more quickly, and marketing, sales, and service people can communicate more precisely and effectively. Gen AI, of course, also plays on the runtime side as well. For example, one of our coolest new Gen AI features that we call Chat with Your Data lets business analysts explore data more easily using our insights capabilities. I think it's really impressive that we've delivered so much in such short order. It really speaks to the power of Pega's platform and our situational layer cake, and the potential here for you as our customers is enormous. So that's all a really good segue to one of the first and perhaps most visual ways we've tied Process AI and Gen AI together, and that is with our Gen AI prediction widget. The widget and overlay were just introduced in our last release, Pega 8.8. We've extended it with Gen AI to provide operators with a written interpretation and a summary of the result of the prediction that's been injected into the case at hand. This makes it easier to convey the information for downstream use. In a future release, we plan to extend this capability and provide more proactive advice when it's needed to address any issues that are identified by the artificial intelligence. We've got a ton to cover, so I'm going to turn it back over to Ivar to take us through a couple of our key new features.
Yeah, thanks. I want to introduce case classification, which is a totally new use case we're supporting in Process AI. And I'm really enthusiastic about it because I think it can mean a lot in many different types of cases, case types throughout many different industries. So let me explain what it does. It uses AI to classify a case. So you would typically have a category field inside your case, and natural language processing is used to detect the class or the category of each specific case. There's also learning involved. So feedback is sent when the case is resolved so that it can be used in the next learning cycle. And this is all really easy to set up. So with this new feature, case classification, we're really making it easy to use NLP within your cases. The benefits are that if you know how to classify a case, you can make sure that it gets to the right person as soon as possible. So this really prevents reassignments of cases. Of course, it means you can handle cases faster. So cases would be handled quicker. And if there's an end customer involved, that of course increases the experience for them, because cases are just resolved more quickly and without reassignment. So also the end user experience really benefits from this. And the main use case for this is intelligent routing. So let me illustrate this with a short demo in the actual product on how case classification for intelligent routing works. Yeah, so here we have a simple application in Pega, and we're looking at the data model. And in this data model, we have a field called accident category. This is actually an example taken from insurance. So there are insurance claims, accidents, car accidents. And one of the fields is the accident category. If we go into the configure mode of that field, we see that it's a drop-down list. It has some possible values like property damage, bodily injury, etc. And here's the new functionality we're adding. Use AI to predict the value of this field. So we can now check this checkbox. We can specify where the input should come from. So the category will be predicted using this description. So there will be a description of the accident, and that will be used as an input. The natural language processing will take that as the input and determine whether the category should be property damage, bodily injury, etc. And there's also a confidence level that has a default value here. So this is how easy it is to configure. Now, if I click submit here, it actually generates all the NLP artifacts that are needed in the background. So it sets up everything, including the feedback loop that the NLP model can use to keep learning from more cases. And how do we use this in a case? Well, let's go to the workflow. And then we could show an example here where we have some routing logic in one of the steps. So this is where we decide, okay, to which work queue should this case be routed? And now we can directly refer to possible values of accident category. In the background, the NLP model will use the predicted category, and it will know whether it's a property damage, a bodily injury, or other value, and then make sure it gets to the right work queue in this way. And moving on to the next feature we're introducing in Infinity 23, improved SLA prediction. So here we are predicting the probability that a case will miss the service level agreement. And although you could already do that in previous versions, we've really made it easy now. So it has its own template now. When you create a prediction, you just select the missing SLA template. And it's defined by a true-false field, which indicates whether the SLA is missed or not. And this can be completely hooked up with the existing goals and deadlines in our platform. So you can automatically make sure that the two cooperate. And the benefits here, of course, are clear. If you're able to predict which cases have a high risk of missing the SLA, then you can take action. For example, make sure it is routed to an expert user. And in that way, you can prevent many cases from missing the SLA. Similarly, we now have what we call custom predictions, which allow you to predict not only the SLA, but basically any field. So anything that may occur during the case lifecycle might be beneficial to predict. For example, a case might be referred, a case might be escalated, a case might be abandoned in a certain stage, and those can all be vital outcomes that you want to predict. So you can create a prediction for that, and at that point you can choose whether you want to use our adaptive models, which are our self-learning models, or you can potentially bring your own predictive model if you have a predictive model already for that. If you're using adaptive models, the feedback comes in, again, by identifying it comes in through a true false field. And that provides the adaptive model this feedback cycle through which it can learn. So this really opens a whole scope of capabilities of any outcomes you may want to predict inside a case lifecycle. And the benefits are clear. If it's a bad outcome, predicting the bad outcome and seeing that the probability is high for a particular case would give you, of course, options to prevent that outcome. But you can also predict a good outcome. Plus, you can prioritize your work based on these predictions. And with that, it's back to you, Andy.
All right. Thanks, Ivar. Well, I got to tell you, I think that the custom predictions, the ability to predict any field is one of those, you know, really what I like to call every, you know, I think every release has one of these, you know, what I would call a small but mighty feature. You know, pretty straightforward, but I think it's going to provide a ton of utility and a ton of business benefit to our customers. So moving on, when we mentioned at the top, we mentioned that we've made it even easier for you to inject artificial intelligence directly into your business processes. And probably the key way we've done that is by the introduction of a new field type called predictions. The short version here is that a prediction can be used like any other field in the system, you know, making the application of AI that much easier and that much more flexible. If you, for those that have used process AI in the past, there is no longer a need to go into settings to configure predictions for a given case type. And you, everything is just done through the data model. It kind of shifts us, if you will, from more of a pool model to a push model, where in version 8.8 and earlier, you had to go in, look to see if there were new predictions available, bring it in your case type, and then it was ready for use. Now, once a prediction is created, it's just there. It's just part of your data model, and there's really no training required to use the predictions in your business processes going forward. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at this new feature. So as you see, our new prediction, What's New in Infinity 23, has been created in Prediction Studio. And rather than having to go into settings in App Studio and look to see if new predictions are available for my use or not, all I have to do now is just go into App Studio, and the predictions are automatically pushed directly into my data model. So if I go back to my data model, recall before there was not a field that started with What's New in Infinity 23. Now there is. And you can see that it's designated as a prediction by looking at the What's New in Infinity 23. If I were to click on this link, it would take me back to the same prediction in Prediction Studio. And as with any other field here, I can use this for decisioning or for any other purpose within a case type. Okay, so we have a lot to cover, so we need to move quickly, but I'd be remiss to not highlight our new decision management portal. As the name implies, it provides a one-stop shop for accessing and managing key process AI capabilities, including decision strategies and event strategies. Moving on, our new subflow shape. So if you're not familiar, data flows are one of the key building blocks of process AI. A data flow is essentially a scalable data pipeline that's used to ingest, process, and move data. Data flows can be used to run decisions, perform text analysis, execute real-time data aggregations, and processes both in real-time and in batch. The new subflow shape extends their utility quite a bit. The subflow provides a visual way to nest data flows and for the same subflow to be referenced by multiple parent flows. This provides a much higher degree of reuse, and it will help ensure consistency in processing logic across multiple data flows. We have only a few more things to cover, so I'm going to turn it right back over to Ivar to bring us home.
Yes, thanks, Andy. Yes, it's a lot. I only want to add a few more comments on additional enhancements that will be there in this Infinity 23 release. The prediction widget will be available in the Constellation framework, where before it was already available in other UI frameworks. It's now also being added in Constellation. The adaptive modeling algorithm that we have, one of them is called gradient boosting, adaptive gradient boosting. There have been some improvements on that algorithm that are being included. Plus also we have a way of explaining those more complex types of decisions using an algorithm called TreeShep. Which the data scientists watching this will understand. Then finally, there's always more information available that you can look up via the homepage, via our documentation, of course. Pega Academy is really important. Pega Academy will include the latest of the latest. So some of these new features will immediately be featured also in the Academy. So look at that. on the academy as well, we have certifications that you can get for process AI, and if you want to do more for data scientist. On Pega Marketplace, I want to mention we have an application, a process AI demo application that you can download yourself, and you can take it apart. It has some of these scenarios that you can walk through and see how it really works. So that you can find on Pega Marketplace.
All right. Well, thanks, Ivar. And thanks, everybody, again, for joining us today. As you can see, Infinity 23 is a really exciting new release for us, especially for Process AI. For our clients, Process AI is a proven game changer, and we encourage you to check it out. Before we wrap up, I'd like to give a special shout out to our product and engineering teams for delivering so much cool new functionality in Process AI. Thanks, everybody. And thank you again for listening in. We have a great team to support Process AI. Please be sure to take advantage of both our online resources as well as reach out via your account team to learn more about Process AI. Thanks and have a great day.